And good afternoon, everybody. How are you guys doing this Thursday? Great to see you here all so early. First, a little bit of a PSA. This Saturday, I will not be streaming. So we're going to get that out of the way right from the get-go. But I do want to thank you all for joining in. Let's see, who do we got in the chat? James, Mickey, Curtis, Terry, Jim, let's see, Curtis, Ark. I know Paul was in the chat earlier. There is Dances with Tarmac, a.k.a. Bob. Crizzy, how is it going? Paul, great to see you. So, yeah, we are going to be out in the Mac Anthem today. We are on the 140 beta. Latest build number is 1.40.0.72. Today's beta update was huge. 1 gigabyte. So, yeah, this is going to be a very big update once it is released to everybody. Hey, Kirk, how's it going today? So, I am running some mods still. Now, one particular mod is going to be for the Mac Anthem here, and that is for the hood. SES kind of does have it modeled incorrectly. So, once we hop inside today, we are not going to be seeing the Bulldog. But right now, we are sitting here in Vernal, Utah. First run today is going to be a load of nitrocellulose going down to Prim. So, and underneath the hood, we have Creech Bomb Sounds today, version 3.5 of that engine mod. We are going to be running a 585 MP8, 18-speed transmission. So, without any further waiting, let's climb into the truck, get her fired up, and let's do some trucking.
Please proceed to the highlighted route.
Now, you guys can see they're right on the hood. Yeah, everything here on the interior side is pretty much modeled correctly for the Anthem. I have no idea why my shifter does that. That's annoying as could be.
Turn left. Turn right.
And before we get too far down the road, since I've been messing around a little bit today, we are going to have to stop and get some go-go juice.
If possible, please turn around. In 650 feet, turn right.
Hey, Big Dub, how's it going today? Omar, great to see you this afternoon.
In 650 feet, turn right. Turn right.
seems like another thing they fixed. If you guys remember, if you paid attention to the wheel, you would see it flopping on the camber in and out when you turned. That is no longer happening. And that's what happens when you go into first gear, and I definitely shouldn't have moved the range selector. Oops. I am a moron today already when it comes to driving.
Navigation resume. Navigation resume. Navigation resume. Navigation resume. Use the right lane ahead.
Yeah, let's see how bad I can actually get lost today, because heaven knows the GPS is going to be right, but Coda never is. Yeah, and actually, most of the railroad crossing flares are now showing up during the daytime, too. And it is getting there, guys. It's, trust me, they'll get all the bugs pretty, well, not all of them, but a good majority of them squashed even before this gets released. They're actually not bad, Kirk. And I'd rather see the new model 579 over the next gen T680, but that's just me. Hey, Junior, how's it going today?
Keep to the left, and then turn left. Turn left.
So I do have to admit, running the mod by IceCat, which fixes the front hood and lowering that bulldog, and I used to use that bulldog to line myself up in the lane. Well, here's the thing about lining yourself up in the lane too. If you guys did not know, if you sit as a driver right in the middle of the lane, the truck is going to be in the middle of your lane.
In 650 feet, turn right. Turn right.
that is a bad place for a breakdown. And there's not even a cop there watching it. And I think, Randy, you mentioned about the traffic lights. It seems like they've gone more back to the LED look of them, to be honest. Whoop, and I am in the wrong lane. That's probably why I was in the left lane, so I don't have to deal with AI traffic. Now, one thing I mentioned on a stream last week about the way station open signs with the flashing lights, there are several of them here in Utah. We'll be going by one when we get down around St. George. Those, as The way stations in the game are open 24/7. The signs are only going to say open and the lights are going to flash. They're not going to be off when the way station is closed. More than likely, they'll have a million people whining and complaining because the Skoda is gone. Probably also has a lot to do that the interior of the Escort vans or trucks or whatever here in the game, they're not really modeled, so that would be something that they would have to add. Oh, I mean, that's probably the one thing I hate about Daniel's random events is you get something like that that pops up out of nowhere, and where I have my braking intensity at, yeah, you are not gonna stop in time. I think the last thing that we need, well, myself personally, is more car mods for Truckers MP. There's enough trolls that use them already. Oh, that was only a slight bumper adjustment, James. I was just putting it back in place. mean, I'm more curious if we're ever going to see like an 8x4 or 8x6 in traffic, even the 4x2s. Engine brake restriction next 3 miles? Nah, we're just gonna keep it on. Would it be bad of me to say don't know and don't care? Yeah, the AI is being stupid. So this bridge right up here is where we're gonna see that waystation open sign. There it is, the white sign sitting right there.
Navigation resumed.
And I know the reason why we got pulled in, because we're hauling hazmat. And we're overweight. Tony, how are you doing? Hey, Dances with Tarmac, you're being a little quiet today. See you, Chrissy. Hey, what do you know? We got a trailer on fire. Now I just want to sit and go, fire, fire, fire. Nah, his name's not James, it's Dario. Yeah, if one of my 227 inches blow up, I'm gonna have to roll back to a 24 inch, which probably is gonna look tiny. Those clouds, however, they gonna need to work on those. Those look a little low resolution to me.
Use the left lane ahead.
I did not know that arc.
Use the left lane ahead.
Sorry there, Miss Google. Why would I want to go on Russell Road?
Navigation resumed. In 650 feet, turn right. Turn right. In 650 feet, turn right. Turn right. You have arrived at your destination.
This is going to be an interesting backdrop. James goes vroom vroom. I mean Dario. Well, I screwed that up. Better than doing a blindside, though, I'll put it that way. And what do you know? Screw up times two. I don't care about being in here straight, we got in here. Alright, we're probably gonna pull out of here. Let's see what we got. That's going back up the same way we just went there. Let's check externals. Yeah, we're not going to Sterling. So let's see what is down at Walbert here. Oh, nothing, only chems. Okay. What do we got in Vegas? Alright, we're gonna go, I wanted to go to Reno anyway, so I'm just gonna quickly put myself over into Vegas. Well, actually, we'll drive up, it's not that far. Let's go ahead and take another hazmat load. This time, going to the biggest little city in the world. Yeah, that's called me not stepping on the clutch there, James.
Turn left.
They really need to manage how to configure the AI to move left to allow us to merge. They seriously do.
Turn right. Turn left. Keep to the right, and then turn right. Turn right. Keep to the left, and then turn left. Turn left.
Now, I was doing other things last night, Paul. Actually, my brother got in yesterday, so kind of did not want to drive today with the storm going through with an empty trailer, and I really can't blame him. Hello, Muhammad. Welcome to the stream. And I know we can't bump the dock here, so we're in the slot. Let's get loaded.
Please proceed to the highlighted route. Turn right. In 650 feet, turn right. Turn right.
Reno. Anybody want to see the fluffy razors?
To the left, and then turn left.
I am in the wrong lane. Whoops. That's what I get for running into the bus behind me.
Turn left.
See, and I can't even blindly follow a GPS without screwing up. That was called the trailer tattoo. Ah, thank you, Randy. I knew something was wrong today. Apparently, I can't see. Yeah, let's go 70 to 25. What a moron. Idiotic Volvo driver.
In 650 feet, turn right.
Hey, Dan, how's it going today?
Turn right.
Hey, good evening, Star. Great to see you. Appreciate it, Star, and that would be this Saturday. Oh, no worries. Yeah, that's been happening a lot lately, Spurs, and that's not to only you. From what a fix that I heard would be unsubscribing, resubscribing, and then re-enabling the notifications. Ethan, Miguel, how's it going today, guys?
in 650 feet, turn left. Turn left.
Doing awesome like a possum, Ethan. And you definitely be careful, Miguel.
In 650 feet, turn right. Turn right.
I can't even keep the truck between the white lines today. Well, the lines, I should say, the zipper and the white line. I keep running over the rumble strip. Duh. Yeah, take a look, Miguel. You can, the hood is definitely more sloped here on the interior. Can't even see the bulldog unless I lean up. Yes, it is, Ethan. There's a little bit of a screw up with the official model from SCS. They got the hood way too high.
Keep to the right, and then continue straight.
Well, I wouldn't mind them seeing they if you're going to be running a shifter like I am to have it actually modeled. I know before the Lone Star release they showed the interior had it in there, but of course the final version never got it.
Use the right lane ahead. Keep to the right, and then turn right. Turn right.
Now, one thing that they currently are missing on the truck, however, is the turn signals right above the headlights. Those are also running lights. They're kind of not lit up. might get that with a tuning pack by chance.
Use the left lane ahead. Use the left lane ahead.
And also, one you can definitely see it now, but here in nighttime, even though if we go outside they'll look like incandescents, the flares from inside the cab here no longer look like that. They look like they are more LED. I mean, so it looks like they are maybe going back and changing some of the flares themselves. So this one here, you can see what I mean, how it acts like an incandescent. So I don't know if they're going to change it on the trucks, but definitely the flares that are shining, they're more LED than anything. That's exactly true there, Bob. I mean, the more they add to the interiors, less FPS is gonna be.
Use the left lane ahead. Keep to the right, and then take the exit on the right. Use the right exit ahead. Keep to the right, and then take the exit on the right. Use the right exit ahead. Turn left. Keep to the left, and then turn left. Turn left.
Yeah, so there's a good look what I was talking about there, that there's no parking lights on the front of the truck.
You have arrived at your destination.
This is my get out and look. We're gonna have to cut it and hopefully we'll be all right and not slam that other trailer. We're close, but we didn't hit it. Yep, they are washed out. What do we got here? Nothing. Absolutely nothing for a reefer in Reno? Are you kidding me? Alright, I know what mod is doing that. Give me a second here, guys. And we're gonna have to take out the cargo rework mod. Apparently that still causes issues of not being able to find any jobs. Please don't reset us back to my home garage. And it did. Lovely. That's right, we're just back in Seattle. Alright, where are we gonna go? I guess let's go over to the port and take a load of ice cream over to Grangeville.
Please proceed to the highlighted route. Keep to the right, and then turn right. Turn right.
Yeah, and even here in the middle of the night, come on. Coda, what are you doing today? Yeah, those colors on the traffic light still look a little washed out.
To the right, and then take the exit on the right. Use the right exit ahead. Keep to the right, and then turn right. Turn right. Use the right lane ahead.
Stupid car. Really? Hello? I had a green light, you moron.
Use the right lane ahead.
Hey, Richard, how's it going today?
You have arrived at your destination.
Welcome back. If I would have known exactly where that was, I could have done a straight in on it, but guess we're gonna back in. Coda don't know his way around the Port of Seattle, apparently. And I have no idea where the hell I'm going. I'm just making it difficult, apparently. We're still in here.
Please proceed to the highlighted route.
Are you sure it was the Bob School of Backing and not just Coda being a rookie? Hey, Staple, what's going on today?
Keep to the left, and then take the exit on the left.
Alright, take care, Miguel. You be extremely safe out there. Mother Nature is not nice tonight.
Use the left exit ahead.
Whoops! I guess we kinda sideswiped that vehicle. Yeah, apparently I don't know where the hell I'm going. It said left lane and the GPS looked like it was supposed to be in the right. Yeah, Coda does not know how to drive. I am such a moron. And we damaged the load, but I want to know how you can damage ice cream. Might have something to do with that I'm half falling asleep right now, too.
Use the right lane ahead. Keep to the left, and then continue straight.
Oh yeah, we can't forget, we still gotta get our echo tests in and things like that, so, ain't one of the best places to do it is going through a tunnel. Yeah, I did see the next gen T680. It doesn't look like a bad truck at all, to be honest with you. And it's just a upgraded model. I've no idea if we'll get it in game. Same with the new model 579. Oh, how typical of Washington. Pull me into a chicken coop.
Navigation resumed.
And that's what happens when you got too much damage. You get a nice little fine. Yeah, such as like taking triples through California. That's a no-no.
use the right lane ahead.
Heck, four-wheeler! We're actually gonna pull off this next exit here. We are gonna, looks like we need more go-go juice, and we're also gonna repair the truck.
Navigation resumed. Turn right. Keep to the left, and then take the exit on the left. Use the left exit ahead. Navigation resumed.
Yeah, I guess packaging damage would count for load damage. I forgot about that. But then, it's Thursday, my brain is totally not here. Hasn't been all day long.
Navigation resumed. Thank you.
just wonder how much this is going to cost to repair. Haha, $322 out of 13,000 total damage, over $16,000. Wow. All right, that's why you got good insurance.
Navigation resumed. Navigation resumed. Navigation resumed. In 650 feet, turn left. Turn left.
Oh, definitely a staple.
That wouldn't surprise me one bit, Randy.
I must have the worst luck when it comes to these way stations. I get pulled into just about every single one. It doesn't even matter what state I'm in. Right at the limit.
the right exit ahead.
Apparently, so there are dances with tarmac. Jonathan, how's it going today? We'll see if this is going to be the last run or not. I mean, I'm kind of half falling asleep. It's been one of those days. So we'll see once we get over here to Grangeville.
Use the left lane ahead.
Chances are I just took a look at the time. More than likely, this will be the last run. The only 49X that I'm showing here that I've seen in the beta still has been the day cab. What do you know? Another one. Lord have mercy, I got a bypass? That's impossible.
In 650 feet, turn left. Turn left.
I'm probably going to wait a little bit on that one, Jim. I know I checked his page yesterday, but I'm going to wait for 140 to go final before I run any of John's trucks.
750 feet. Turn right. Turn right. The right lane ahead. In 650 feet, turn right. Turn right.
Talking about drill modding, Omar? Yeah, that's because Joe moved to a paid mod system through Patreon. And to be honest, I wouldn't pay to join his Patreon, because his trailers, I think, are absolute trash. What's going on today, Ahmed? And I have ran them before, Omar, and I'm not saying that to be a mean person or anything, but his trailers are extremely FPS heavy, and the models are way too high poly for the game. But I understand why he does. He wants something that looks good, but it shouldn't be sacrificed at the cost of a player's FPS, would be my gist, if you will. And if he is moving to Patreon, he better come up with some type of system to where he can update the mods pretty darn quickly, because otherwise, it takes him forever, and literally forever, to get anything done. Hey, Justin, what's going on today? Oh, probably Washington Staple, but there's only one place in Oregon to where you run into that. You find more of the drawbridges in Washington than anywhere else. Almost like his Vanguard Reaper that I will use an example. When he first uploaded that to Steam, yes, I ran it. Did I like the trailer? It was alright, but it literally took away quite a bit of FPS from me, and also 900 megabyte. Why does a trailer need to be nearly 1 gig? That does not make any sense whatsoever. Great to hear there, Ahmed. And on the utility, the trailer fairings weren't even properly done on there, because they showed like that rainbow chromish color when you attached them. And if Drew is moving to Patreon, which he probably already is, if you had a choice of Drew modding or Bart, trust me, get the Bart mods. They are more than likely going to be more expensive, but they are extremely well worth it. They're not FPS heavy. Everything on them is literally crisp, clear, and extremely well done. Good afternoon, AJ. I'm gonna say later this year. If the second state this year is Texas, livestock hauling down there is gonna be extremely huge. So you really can't do that without having a livestock trailer. And of course, that is one of the most requested trailers that people want to see in the game.
Turn left. In 650 feet, turn left.
Oh, great. Tiny parking lot.
Turn left. You have arrived at your destination.
And they want it right next to the building. Okie dokie. The only way cattle is going into a reefer is if it's in a box after it's butchered. All right, guys, I know today my driving was not the best. So, I mean, if you guys still enjoyed the stream, make sure you leave a thumbs up. If you thought I could have drove better, leave a thumbs down. Feedback is still very important to me. I hope you guys have a great rest of your Thursday evenings. Probably, again, Saturday, I will not be here. Chances are we will see you back again here on Sunday for episode number 128 of Sundays Are for Trucking. Have a great rest of your Thursday nights. As always, keep that shiny side up, and we'll catch you on the flip-flop.